The Nissan GT-R was unveiled in 2007 as a high-performance sports car and grand tower. It succeeds the Skyline GT-R, a Nissan Skyline high-performance variant. Nissan has shortened the GT-R range to 2021, removing the 50th anniversary version and track edition trimmings. The second shift in the model year 2021 is that the color of Bayside Blue is now on the premium trim. Somehow, for a car that costs less than the first car, Nissan charged six figures nearly a decade ago, and since then, it has not changed much. However, there's no question of price for those wanting permanent seating time in the most powerful vehicle. Since the ultimate version of this model is in the Nismo, it costs more than the exotic McLaren 570 and Porsche 911 Turbo S. Now we're going to discuss the Nissan GT-R in this video review. Don't forget to click the like button. And be sure to subscribe to watch great video clips like this to enhance your knowledge. Engine, transmission, and performance. The 2021 GT-R Standard 3.8-liter V6 twin-turbo produces a powerful 565 horsepower. It hooks an automatic six-speed drive and an all-road drive, which conspires to bring all this power into the pavement. The GT-R started on our test track in just 2.9 seconds, from 0 to 60 miles per hour. Even amateurs behind the wheel will feel positively heroic with the GT-R's steering, rigid framework, and adjustable suspension. Would you like more? Take a look at the track edition of the Nismo versions with a 600-horsepower tuned engine. The ride is steady but not punishable, and the GT-R does not punish your eardrums on highway cruising with the active cancellation of sound. Fuel economy and real-world miles per gallon. The EPA predicts GT-R earns 16 miles per gallon per year in the city and 22 miles per gallon per year on the highway every 2021. However, we don't know the real world because we didn't try it on our fuel economy route of 200 miles. Interior, comfort, and cargo. The GT-R front seats are very spacious, but the rear seats can find comfort for only small children. The interior is well designed with many regular features, but people looking for a top-of-the-line interior like the Audi R8 or the Mercedes AMG GT are disappointed. Each model has a dual-zone climate control, leather and suede covering, heated front seats, and more. Indoor storage is limited by nothing but big door pockets and a small middle console. Infotainment and connectivity. The 8-inch touchscreen that can also be operated with a rotating knob on the center console is provided for each 2021 GT-R, although Apple CarPlay, integrated browsing, and Bose are the standard audio system. Android Auto isn't an option. Its infotainment system is easy to use, even though it's not the most appealing graphics and menus. Safety and driver assistance features. The 2021 GT-R was not reviewed by the NHTSA and National Highway Traffic or the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety, IIHS. The NHTSA was not a crash test, IIHS. You won't find any of the driver support features here, but to be honest, in most GT-R competitors, those types of electronics are also not commonplace. Passenger and boot space. The Nissan GT-R is one of the most usable sports cars by combining two occasional back seating and a boot of 315 liters. The car is an excellent boat, big enough to fit various golf clubs and deep enough for a few soft holdings. The back seats of the vehicle do not bend over because there is no longer a passageway. The back seats might be large enough to allow a young adolescent, but none larger. ISOFIX anchor points for children, making it realistic to take younger children and leave a decent space in the back. Space is okay instead of excellent in the driver's seat. The controls are in good position. Unusually, the steering column has separate release levers, depending on whether you want to change the rake or the reach, so it's a fiddler to move the wheel. You can position it where you like at least, and the tools shift the column so that you don't have to worry about obscuring it with the bottom. Similarly, internal storage is good but not excellent. The center console has a few large cup holders that can accommodate bottles and bagpipes, but the storage cubby is shorter at the end of the driver's armrest, and the door and the glove box are tiny. Costs and verdict. Six airbags, keyless start, 20-inch wheels, LED headlight systems, and standard parking sensors, as well as an 11-speaker infotainment system, a radio with DAB and SD-based satellites, are also included in the GT-R entrance level. It is precisely the generous package that a car like this usually offers because it is a bit long. The step up to mid-level trim looks a little costly as it buys only Recaro sports seats and some other cabin trimming parts. The Prestige version has extended black, red, ivory, or tan for luxury tastes. In contrast, the Track Edition has fabricated wheels, an enhanced body, and a track-focused suspension, as well as carbon fiber spoiler. The Nismo Edition features Recaro carbon fiber seats, Alcantara polishing, Nismo Body Kit carbon fiber curbside panels, carbon fiber wing, and splitter, Ford's 20 and Ray's alloy wheels, suspension Bilstein, more powerful turbochargers, and carbon ceramic brakes. It's the latest edition of the GTR, but you're going to pay the luxury price if you want one on your trip. It costs you more than an Audi R8, McLaren GT, or Ferrari Rome. At least residual car prices should be competitive. After 3 years and 36,000 miles, it is supposed to maintain approximately 50% of its showroom value. This is similar to the pace of Audi R8 or McLaren GT depreciation. Warranty and maintenance coverage. Complimentary scheduled maintenance does not mean a lot, but some competitors provide it when Nissan does not. It is also less than the other competitors that sell 4 years or 50,000 miles with a small guaranteed duration. Thank you very much for watching. Share a comment below and remember to subscribe to get my next video.